the line spectrum of hydrogen atom. Let us now discuss it quantitatively by using the Bohr's atomic model. We have also discussed in case of Bohr postulate in the second point that when an electron is excited from lower principal quantum number to higher principal quantum number, then energy is absorbed, and when an electron moves from higher quantum number to lower quantum number, then energy is released. Let us know how much energy is released when excitation and de-excitation of electron takes place between two principal quantum number. Let us see. When electron moves from one quantum number, one principal quantum number, from one orbit to another orbit, then the difference in the energy of the orbit is represented as delta E final minus E initial. We know according to Bohr, what we have, E equals to minus R H by L. When where R H is Rydberg's constant and N is principal quantum number. Putting these values in this equation, what we have, delta E equals to minus R H minus R H by N final minus R H by N initial. By rearranging it, what we have, minus R H N final minus plus R H by N initial. What we got? Minus R H as common. We have N 1 by N initial minus 1 by N final. We know why? We know the value of RH is equals to 2.18 into 10 to the power 18 minus 18 joules. Putting the value of RH here, what do you got? Delta E or delta E equals to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18 joules. Multiplied by 1 by Ni minus 1 by Nf. To the next. R. We know E equals to H mu, or we can say mu equals to E upon H. Then in order to get it, we have delta E. Then what we should write here? We should write what E by H equals to mu. It means mu equals to delta E by H. H mu, what I have taken, E equals to H mu. But I want to get mu, then we divide E by H. On dividing delta E by H, what we have, it is equals to 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18 joule compared to 1 by N initial minus 1 by N final. It is divided by the value of Planck's constant, that is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34. On simplifying it, when we simplified it, what we got? We got 2.18 divided by 6.626. When it moves here into, it forms plus 34. Ten to the power 16. It becomes 1 by n I minus 1 by n f. When we simplify it, what we got? We got 2 1 2 9 18. 2 3 6, 2 3 6, 2 1 2 3 6. When we simplified it, what we got? We got 3.29 into 10 to the power 15, 1 by n I minus 1 by n f. If we want to get wave number, wave number, we know it is equals to mu equals to c upon lambda. We know mu equals to c upon lambda. Putting its value, what we have here? Here we have mu. Mu equals to c upon lambda. In order to get lambda, what we have? 1 by lambda equals to V bar, it is equals to 3.29 into 10 to the power 15, 1 by N I minus 1 by N F, dividing by C, that is 3 into 10 to the power, 3 into 10 to the power 8. What we got? We got here. Or we can say mu bar, it is equals to 1.09677 into 10 to the power 7 multiplied by 1 by n I square minus 1 by n f square. This is how we can represent the difference in the energy of the two orbitals and the frequency or the energy of immediate radiation. हमने क्या किया है? हम देख रहे हैं कि transition. Transition में क्या है? If this one is the nucleus and this one is the first energy, ground state, this one is the second, then what we know? Energy is absorbed when electron is excited to higher energy state. Then energy is absorbed. But in case When electron re-excites from higher energy state to lower, then energy is released. What happened? Let us see. एनर्जी डिफरेंस, अगर दो ऑर्बिटल्स हैं, दो ऑर्बिट है एक एटम में, तो एनर्जी डिफरेंस को हम रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं E फाइनल माई E इनिशियल. तो डेल्टा E चेंज इन एनर्जी, डिफरेंस इन एनर्जी, E फाइनल माइनस E इनिशियल. बोस के अकॉर्डिंग, पॉस्टुलेट्स के अकॉर्डिंग हम जानते हैं कि जो एनर्जी होती है किसी ऑर्बिट की, दैट शुड बी माइनस आर एच बाई एन स्क्वायर. Putting इस वैल्यू को रखने पे, putting these values, what we have, delta E equals to minus R H by N F square, here F minus minus R H by N I square. On simplifying it, what we have, this we have minus R H as such and N F square as such, minus minus plus R H by N I square. At same positions, what we have, delta E taking RH as common, what we have, this RH and I initial square by 1 by NF square. We know the value of RH is 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18 joule. Putting this value here, we have the equation. Delta E equals to 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18 joule. 1 by N I square minus 1 by N F square. If you want to get mu frequency, so in case of frequency we know E equals to H mu. When we divide E by H, we got mu. Here we have E, when we divide E by H, we got mu. Dividing E by H, what we have, 2.18 into 10 to the power 18 joule, 2.18 into 10 to the power 18 joule, 1 by Ni square minus 1 by Nf square, divided by the value of Planck's constant, that is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34. When we simplify it, what we got? We got mu equals to 3.29 into 10 to the power 15, 1 by N I square minus 1 by N F square. We know mu equals to C upon lambda. When we got, putting the value of mu here, C upon lambda, we have the value of this one. If we want to get 1 by lambda, then we have to move the C here. And what we have, 3.29 into 10 to the power 15 divided by the value of C, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8, 1 by Ni square minus 1 by Nf square. Then we got 1 by lambda or mu or V bar, wave number. We have 1.096 into 10 to the power 7, 1 by Ni square minus 1 by Nf square. Of this case, mein, we will see, in case Nf is greater than, in case NF is greater than NI. If NF is greater than NI, then this fraction will be lower in comparison to this. If अगर ये NF जो है NI से बड़ा होगा, तो ये बड़ा होगा तो इसकी पूरी वैल्यू जो होगी, क्योंकि ये डिनोमिनेटर में है, तो इसकी पूरी वैल्यू क्या हो जाएगी, कम हो जाएगी, और ये वैल्यू हमको पॉजिटिव मिलेगी. इसका मतलब ये है कि अगर हमारे पास फाइनल जो है शेल जो है, स्टेशनरी स्टेट जो है, वो बड़ा है और इनिशियल छोटा है, तो इस केस में हमें जो वैल्यू मिलेगी वो एनर्जी की, वो पॉजिटिव मिलेगी. हियर वो हमें पॉजिटिव मिलेगी और वो रिप्रेजेंट करती है कि एनर्जी अब्सॉर्ब हो रही है. व्हाट इट मींस, लेट अस राइट इट हियर. इन केस पॉइंट नंबर वन, In case NF is greater than NI, it means final बड़ा है initial से, it means the electron is moving from lower energy level to higher energy level. तो जब इलेक्ट्रॉन लोअर एनर्जी लेवल से हायर एनर्जी लेवल में जाता है तभी तो फाइनल बड़ा होगा इनिशियल से, और जब फाइनल बड़ा होगा, जब ये फाइनल बड़ा है इनिशियल से, तो फिर ये 1/f की वैल्यू कम होगी और 1/ni की वैल्यू अधिक होगी, तो हमें जो एनर्जी मिलेगी वो पॉजिटिव होगी. देन द एनर्जी विच वी ऑब्टेन from the equation is positive. तो ये हमें वैल्यू क्या मिलेगी? पॉजिटिव मिलेगी, which shows that energy is absorbed. पहला केस. दूसरा केस, अगर मानते हैं कि एन आई बड़ा है, तो क्या होगा? एन आई बड़ा होगा यानी कि इलेक्ट्रॉन हाई एनर्जी स्टेट में था, और एन एफ छोटा होगा मतलब हायर से वो लोअर आ रहा है. तो एन आई बड़ा होगा तो ये पूरा फ्रैक्शन छोटा हो जाएगा, और ये माइनस वाला बड़ा हो जाएगा तो पूरा एनर्जी हमारी निगेटिव हो जाएगी. इसका मतलब दूसरा, इन केस एन आई इज ग्रेटर देन एन एफ, इट मीन्स द इलेक्ट्रॉन इज मूविंग फ्रॉम हायर एनर्जी state to lower energy state. Higher energy state से वो lower energy state में आ रहा है. Then the energy which we obtain from the equation is negative, which shows that energy is released. यहां क्या है? इस केस में n जो हमारा इनिशियल है, इनिशियल मतलब पहला, वो बड़ा है, इसका मतलब इलेक्ट्रॉन हाई एनर्जी स्टेट में है. फाइनल छोटा है यानी कि लोअर एनर्जी स्टेट में आ रहा है. अगर ये बड़ा है तो उसकी वैल्यू छोटी हो जाएगी और उसकी वैल्यू बड़ी हो जाएगी, 1/nf की वैल्यू बड़ी. तो फिर जब माइनस करेंगे तो ये वाली वैल्यू बच जाएगी, और ये माइनस इस एनर्जी को माइनस कर देगा, और माइनस एनर्जी रिप्रेजेंट करती है उसमें एनर्जी रिलीज हो रही है. ये हमने देखा, क्वांटिटेटिव हमने एस्टिमेशन किया कि जब कोई इलेक्ट्रॉन हायर एनर्जी स्टेट से लोअर एनर्जी स्टेट में जाता है, या कोई इलेक्ट्रॉन लोअर एनर्जी स्टेट से हायर एनर्जी स्टेट में जाता है, तो एनर्जी जो रेडिएट होती है उसकी फ्रिक्वेंसी क्या हो सकती है, उसका वेवलेंथ क्या हो सकता है, उसका वेवलेंथ क्या हो सकता है, उस दो ऑर्बिट के एनर्जी का डिफरेंस क्या हो सकता है. बाय दिस वे वी कैन कैलकुलेट इट क्वांटिटेटिवली. नो डाउट दैट द बोर्स एटॉमिक मॉडल वाज द इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑफ रदरफोर्ड्स एटॉमिक मॉडल, एंड इट वाज एबल टू एक्सप्लेन द स्टेबिलिटी टुगेदर विद द स्पेक्ट्रा, लाइन स्पेक्ट्रा ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम together with hydrogen like atom such as He+, Li2+, Be3+. But after all, do after all this merit, it has certain limitations. What are their limitations? It would not explain the splitting of lines in magnetic and electrical fields, which were observed by the sophisticated technique. The next is that it is unable to explain the line spectrum of multi-electronic atom. It means if an atom contains more than one electron, then that spectra is not explained by Bohr's atomic model. To the next, it does not explain the stability or the chemical bond formed by atoms. It does not explain the process of formation of molecules by combination of atoms. Though these are the limitations of Bohr's atomic model. Let us know it. Limitation of Bohr's atomic model. No doubt, it accounts for the stability and line spectra of hydrogen atom. Or H hydrogen like atom such as Fe plus, Li 2 plus, Be 3 plus, Et 3. But it has certain limitations. What are these? The first one, it fails to account for the finer details it means closely spaced